wondering what you want to be your next step. Do you want to eventually go in once the Emerald Village Eve is up? Would that be a place you want to go? I'm interested in knowing, those of you that are at the Nightingale shelter, what your next step is, or community shelters. So I'm kind of wondering what your plan is, how you would like to, you want to stay where you are, move on, what?
Well, we are kind of looking at a program that I might be able to move into, go through to help with housing. So kind of leaving my options open, although Eve sounds really great, so I'm going to the meetings to try to be as involved as possible in case that comes through too.
I got a windfall a couple months ago, and I'm starting up an IDA, an individual development account, with NEDCO, and right now I'm looking for a new place to go. I've been in OV for almost 2 years, and it's time to move on, basically. Next step after that, I'm going to be fast tracking on the IDA, and the plan is to get together with some other people, maybe get some grants, and start a farm. Yeah, you know, I want to explore our lives and things like that and go forward from there.
To put it this way, I'm in this camp to help other homeless people get on their feet, and through that I'm helping myself every day be a better person and to be there to help more people. I have this ability to help others weaken their walls and see that there is help out there and that there is a good future for them. They just need to figure it out and get it together. So me in this camp is actually learning a lot so we can have bigger camps and run and manage them a lot nicer and comfortable.
Okay, I guess it's me. I'm with the number one camp for CSS. And my son and I are trying to get one of us get a job, and because we can't really move forward until we get some kind of income. Right now our income is very low. And so once we got the job situation and the money coming in, then things will start coming back around for us.
For me, myself, I'm here with my lovely young bride there. Her name's Hope. She's disabled. I'm currently looking for employment here in Eugene. Moved here from Salt Lake. And am now part of the on-site management team for Community Supported Shelters, Safe Spot Number 2, as well as Connie here. A lot of our time right now is really dedicated towards trying to help people get comfortable once they get into our camp, and then from there to help them try to open up and express some of the barriers that they're facing in attaining self-sufficiency. During that time frame, actually, Hope and I are on a waiting list, as it were. When the HACSA here in Eugene did their lottery for 3,000, I think, spots, Hope and I got number 2,100, so we have anywhere from a year to 2, is what the letter said, for our wait time for getting into the housing program. During that time, during that time frame, I've basically been asked to serve our camp as manager. I've asked Connie, who was our original assistant manager, to reprise her role as assistant manager working with me and trying to help people, as Eric's been helping us. We're working on breaking down barriers together. Sorry, I missed that second meeting, by the way. But other than that, Hope and I are becoming plugged in. We're attending Harvest Church International. We're, you know, trying to network with members of the community, trying to feel our way into understanding what it's like to live here in Eugene. We first arrived here September 3rd of last year, so we haven't even been here a full year yet. And in that time frame, we went from sleeping out in the field outside of Highway 99 to being at the mission, getting attacked by one of my best friends. Thank God for Eric and Faye, community supported shelters, and giving Hope and I a chance to be able to have a place to stay. And then from there, there's limitless possibilities on how to go about it. And just finding what resources, finding what steps that can be taken, and what would be right for us is a big part of the journey for any